Hey, welcome back to the channel. So I'll share with you daily habits that hinders young people's ability to control their financial life, like me and you. Okay, let me take a sip of this water and then get you through what I mean. But first, you know what, do this for me. If today happens to be your first time here, I recommend that you subscribe to the channel and what, click the bell icon. We do videos on entrepreneurship, personal financing, and what, everything about money and everything that will empower you as a young individual. The very first one that I'll be talking about is improper use of mobile phones. And the case study that I'm going to use here is social media, how we use social media. You know, most people want to be entertained than to be educated. That's a fact. And we, the young ones, we love to be entertained than to be educated. Yes. And that is why those up above us, maybe those 30, 40, they are mostly in the rich category, because they mostly think of productive things. But we, the young ones, we do more of entertaining things that will give us up to absolutely nothing. So with the proper use of your phone, you'll be able to at least manage your time and then you will not expect any unrealistic, you not get any unrealistic expectations. You know, be there any fear of missing something, like in addictions, missing that. So you can be using social media for a lot of things. Just say for sales, for advertisement, for generating leads, for customer management, a whole lot of stuff that you yourself can be doing it for others. So these behaviors, like using social media poorly, can be turned into a productive way that will help you yourself to at least come up with a very good ideas and then what, make a good income out of that. So one thing that I recommend is you, when you're on the internet, what I do most is to advertise my business and then advertise for others, and then create Facebook ad for others. I've seen that thing, sales, and then do use it for online teaching. So in the next video, I'll be doing ways I make money. Me personally, I make money online, and then my small way, so that you get to know what I really mean. So using the social media positively will have a great impact on your income. So looking at this example, if we take like someone who uses social media for only business, and then he spends about only 4 hours online, and then make about 60 Ghana cedis or $60, and then someone that will be following artists like musicians or maybe popular people, and then be commenting and then defending them online, and then the whole day the person will be spending like $26 a time, and then the person using the business will spend only four hours and then use about 5 cedis or $5 a time. And with this, the person with the one using business will get a productive day, because at the end of the day, with the 5 cedis, is going to generate about 50 cedis or 100 cedis out of that day. And then you, the one following the artist or anything, you rather giving the artist money and then you lose. Have you seen that? So it is important to make sure that you manage, or you know how to properly manage your phone very well. So there are a whole lot of apps that you can download to your phone, so that to help you in time management and what, scheduling your days and everything. I'm not saying that it's more difficult. It is never difficult to do this. So some apps like Airtable, and then if you are using iPhone, you can use the notes part, so that use that part to be doing your daily schedules and those stuff. So you set what you do in the morning, in the afternoon, and in the evening, so that at the end of the day you have a productive day and then achieve something better for yourself. Associating yourself with wrong people. Yes, you know, most people associate themselves with wrong people at a young age. Like, most of the time, I use myself as an example, and then I mostly run with my age mates. But when it comes to business, I go in for those who are older than me. Yes, just because they have the experience that I will learn from. My age mates will be doing the entertainment stuff, and then I'll be doing the business stuff with those who are older than me. And then at the end of the day, I will get a productive day. So there are a lot of signs that you will see that these people are not right for me. Like, they say you don't have what it takes to do what you want, they don't support you in everything that you do, they make you feel unattractive, and all those stuff, all those people around you, making you feel that are not the right people for you. So rather, you look for people that will embrace the ideas that you bring, embrace whatever that you want to support, like whatever that you want to do, they are ready to support. You do all the alternatives of that, and then you make sure that, hey, these people are productive, and whenever we do something, we are going to achieve something out of what we are doing. That is exactly what I mean. So associate yourself with right people, and then be able to be a productive member for that group or anything. So there's a saying that your network is your net worth. Yes, but the people that you network with will definitely determine how productive or successful you are going to be. So taking the successful people in the world as an example, like Bill Gates, Mark and all those stuff, you see how they brought up they with the Facebook and everything, they did it through a collective effort by their friends who are helping them to achieve that. Yes, so with much effort from friends, like very good friends, you'll be able to bring us some things, some ideas in you that will help and bring a productive in its last habits that preventing you from managing your financial life very well is not setting measurable goals. Come to think of this, at the beginning of every year, most people set realistic goals. Like they set goals, but they are not able to achieve it, or they're not attainable. Why? Because the goals are not realistic. Like they are not measurable. They can't be achieved. You may set a whole lot of goals at the end of the year, and then at the end of the year, you see that you've achieved small. Even sometimes you don't achieve any of them. So it is important to set a measurable goal that will help you. At least at the end of the year, you'll be able to see that you have achieved 80% of this. So what are measurable goals? You make sure that hey, at the end of the day, you have goals like maybe I want to make $1,000 at the end of 2020. And then what am I going to do to get it there? How am I going to do it? Who am I going to get it through? How am I going to get this money? And all those stuff. Make sure that you have specifics. Your goals should be smart, so that at the end of the day, you come up with a very strong goal, and then that is attainable or achievable, that is feasible to everyone, and then you'll be able to achieve it by yourself. All right, so guys, these are the behaviors that I have for you, and hey, I hope they help you. I hope you have a useful takeout from it. Let me know in the comment section what you are taking out from these behaviors, or what you are taking out to the house, and then you will start practicing, or if you're practicing it, how you are going to date it from it. And then if you have any problem, let me know in the comment section below so that I help you solve it. It is very important to help each other to build it. You know, this platform is for you and you want to be part of the community. Let's hit the subscription button below so that we all grow together. Thanks for watching and bye bye for now.